Alright, old fella. I collected your stuff. Hello, welcome back to Wytchwood. Wytchwood is it? Oh, it's the graveyard. No. I gotta say it. I gotta do it. It's a joke. It's gotta come every episode. It's Quincy's written label on the back of the lantern. Let's see. See. The crypt crawler's silk is thick and smells oddly of lilac. I seem to have misplaced my reading glasses, so maybe you better prepare the mixture. Read off the well-worn instructions printed on the lantern. They're horribly confusing and riddled with spelling mistakes.
How did these contraptions ever make it to the market in the first place? You better stand back. If I do this wrong, things might get a little explodey.
You grind together the gruesome ingredients into a waxy paste before rendering the whole mixture down over the gay gravekeeper's cooking fire. The odor coming from the wet bubbling soup makes the hairs on your nose prickle, but you power through it and pour the ghastly oil into the lantern with a rusty funnel. I thought it was going to say fuel for some reason. The gravekeeper raises one caterpillar-like eyebrow at you.
No kabim. Perfect. Give her a good shake.
You swish the oil around inside the lamp, light the wick, slowly a bluish, unearthly glow fills the space around you. Take it.
Take a look at that. Fresh as a daisy. Just wave it around. Any wavered goodies, try your kosher.
Try to accost.
I should clear away your miserable banshee. Maybe you should ask her what all the fuss about.
Sure. I'm gonna use it like once, and then all the hands are gonna disappear, right? Oh. And drives the other ghosts away. Okay. Okay. Speak to the banshee in the haunted house. Well, I don't really see a banshee. I see this thing. It's a weeping specter. That's a completely different thing, I suppose. Oh, upstairs. Oh, okay. Hi there. How you doing?
Scree!
Call to taunt me as well. Oh, what the fuck?
Taunt you? I come to find you out why you're throwing such a tantrum. You raise the dead with your wailing.
What? The wraith's jaw drops at her collarbone, howling at her ghostly arms, howling as her ghostly arms reach for you. You quickly raise the ghost lamp high, bathing the room in cold light. The spirit recoils away, covering her eyes with translucent hands.
Yay! It burns! Why do you torment me so? I'll quit being dramatic. Now tell me what's got you so upset. It's gone! That sneak, that thieving blaring rodent stole it! What's gone? Who stole it? My family's crypt was defiled by that wretched rat! My most precious treasure! My brooch, it's gone! I will not rest until I have it back!
I can't really scream.
Ah, the rat stole your brooch from your crib. That's enough to make anyone upset.
Yes, it was stolen, ripped from beast. Where has it gone?
Well, if the rat pilfered it off your remains, maybe he left behind a clue of where you ran off to. But that crypt is damn full of caskets. How will I know which box is yours? What's your name? Don't remember. Who was I? Everything's so clouded by my suffering.
Well, it's your house, right? It's a right direction. I'll get to the bottom of this. Just stop your howling. Oh, hi. I'll see what I can do. I want my brooch back. Sorry. Hold up. The corroded picture frame has almost completely deteriorated. You can barely make out the ghostly figure sitting together in the rotten canvas.
A shame. Time has almost forgotten this family. Maybe I can restore just this little piece of them.
Craft a restorative idol. Hello. There we go. The heavy box seems like it might contain important family documents, but it's locked tight.
I doubt the key is anywhere around here. I better just make my own.
Okay. I have enough for it. Unlock. You crack open the chest to find a collection of moldy papers and bills. But a heavy book at the bottom looks promising. In the cracked leather-bound tome, you browse through long-forgotten obituaries, and we mourn her death, the third of her siblings to pass. Much beloved, she will long be remembered for her beautiful singing voice and tireless pursuit of justice.
Sounds like our banshee, the third to die. That will mean that her casket will be the third one, third in her row.
Oh, that's smart. Sorry, I don't think she'd be there, antlered ghost. It's gonna be a bit of a problem when you're around her. Extinguish that. Wait, no, hold up. Can I see a thing over here? Nope. That's not a thing. The embossed shield looks like it might be a coat of arms, but the face is so badly encrusted with patina that you can't quite make out what it is.
Huh. I got cleaning out to get this quick. Really? Really? I could do everything like this? Oh, piss off. Purification water on
this thing. You clean away the grit and grime, and a real proud lion staring back at you. The crest looks like it matches one of the burial rooms in the crypt. Makes sense to have a lion. It always is in these types of stories for some reason. I don't remember being here. I never went fully to the right. This? I didn't see this. What the fuck is this? Fairy circle. Fey energy converging on this spot, but to what end is unclear. Okay then. Right, this thing. Color and light flood back into the faded painting to reveal a content looking family. You recognize one of the younger girls by her shock of hair. I've never heard that before. God damn, this game is making me realize there are so many words that English just doesn't use regularly. And brooch on her chest.
That must be our wailing wraith, a granddaughter by the looks of it, so she must be on the lower tiers of the crypt. I think that's everything I need to know. Banshee's body is buried under the crest of the line. She's a granddaughter, so she'll be on the bottom row. And she was the third one to pass away.
Okay, that's... what?
Oh, you're back. Find out anything about her predicament.
It seems like you've got a grave robber on the loose. The banshee had a brooch stolen from her family crypt.
A grave robber? Oh, damn these despicable degenerates. With a increase in ghosts, I'll be able to demute nightly patrols.
I need to go to the crypt to find a body. The thief might have left something behind.
I'll get like this. Place more spiders than I'll ever start. Okay.
Okay, this is a pig. That's an owl. Okay, can I... God damn it. That's a lion. Okay, so in this one... Oops. I could just see which one I can interact with. You dig your nails underneath the loose plaque and begin to pull. The rusty bolt pops off the corners. The end of the cap, the whole thing rips apart in the mossy wall. You toss away the grave cover and peer inside the dark hollow. Holding your lamp aloft, dozen of small, beady-eyed blinks back at you. I think I just had a stroke. Goddamn. Rats! You quickly jump aside as the torrent of vermin come pouring out from the coffin.
Filthy little biters, come to pill for some more graves.
Squeaking and hissing, they flow into the lumpy liquid. Rushing back towards the entrance. You get the feeling that these rats are far more organized than any normal pest.
Where are you off to, little devils? Running back to your master, perhaps?
Follow the rats. You attract the swarm of rats into the thorny bramble, the bodies whirling in verminous mass. So this does not, however, seem to be their permanent nest. If you could only flush them out, perhaps they would flee to the true source.
Ah, a good spark ought to set this dry tinder alight. Can't hide from me, beasts.
I don't think I... Oh. Never fucking mind. I'm fucking... Wait. Did they steal from me? I had two healing things. I didn't use them, did I? The brush is quickly subsumed in tongues of flame. I don't care if this is proper English. That is an extreme tongue twister to speak. The hell, man. Scattering the rats beneath. The frenzied rouse is not without order, though. In a wave of fur and claws, they scramble through the graveyard towards the next hiding place. Yeah. Okay. Is it gonna be this thing? The horde of rat pours between the bars of this crumbling mausoleum, swirling in a gyre just out of reach. Once more, they have found temporary refuge.
Such a closed-in space seems ripe for a good smoking. They won't be able to hold their breath for long.
Which I'm going to assume is this. Yep. Ha! Pieces of shit. The smoke I'm emitting from the pellets is thick and concentrated, even though they are below the worst of it. The choking fumes are enough to flush the rats out. Once more, they rush to a fourth, this time fleeing towards the shadow of the ruined church. Up here. Yeah. The flood of rats squeeze through the bars and the great brass gates and disappearing into the ruins of squat behind abandoned church. Heavy chains bind up the gate and the rusty padlock is well beyond accepting any sort of key. Something more potent will be needed to open it. Acidic unguent recipe. Fair enough. I'm not gonna try and... Yeah, I know I can create it, but I wish I could create it quickly by just selecting the ingredients in the recipe. That's the thing I think this game would need. Like, I understand it's all there. Like, it's just there, but still... Oh, yeah, because they created it. Just being able to craft it directly through this selection here would make it a bit more streamlined. I know it sounds lazy, but, you know, quality of life things, okay? It's not a necessary thing for you to use or even know about, but if you find it eventually because you find it more, like, accommodating to you, there you have it. There's an option to do it. The iron of the padlock weeds in protest as it melts away into the blackened goo. The chains falls away and the puss open the gates to the churchyard beyond. Fair enough. Anything over here? Behind the thing? Sorry, it's very thin. The church is very thin. Where am I going? Not down here. Oh, hello. Ha 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 ha! I know my stuff. I'm not stealing anything. The rats stole from others. So I'm just taking what's rightfully other people's. Hello. You attempt to pick up the candlestick, but find it attached to some mechanism inside the altar. A light flips and you watch a stack of boxes slide aside and reveal it in a crack in the wall. Did I say crack or cack? Yo, I do so much crack, I should be able to say it correctly. Hello! That's a lot of gold! I want it! It's not real! It's a hologram! What do you mean? What? I'm swimming through it like Scrooge McDuck! Fuck, man! What? What do you mean it's fake? But I wanted it! God damn it! I feel betrayed! So anyways, hey there, rat man.
Hey, who in blazes are you? Who let you in, huh?
I let myself in. You should really hide your secret there a bit better. Though I must admit, this is quite a collection you've acquired here.
Why? What's it to you? You looking to make a trade? We got whatever you need, sister. If you can pay me the price, that is.
As a matter of fact, I'm looking for an old antique brooch, and I've heard that you're the one to talk to.
Yeah, we got plenty of brooches. Any of these beauties catch your eyes?
The vermin flips open the cloak, and you see it's lined with rows and rows of jewelry. You lean in for a closer look. The items all look like priceless family heirlooms, but you can't pick out the one belonging to the banshee.
I'm not sure. I need to confer with my friend as to which is the right one.
The rat narrows his eyes suspiciously and hides his wares back inside his cloak.
And just who is that friend of yours?
Why, she's the original owner, of course. She would very much like her property returned to her.
No deal. We don't make trades with the dead.
But you're happy enough to steal from them. Let me just go tell my friend where your little hideout is. I'm sure she'll be more persuasive than myself.
Fool! This place is sacred ground. No bad spirits can enter here. Now get out before we pick you clean.
I do wonder that. Like, I don't particularly care or really... Like, I don't particularly know or care whether, like, holy power actually exists. But if it does... Does an old church still retain its, like, holiness, like, its church presence, even when it's demolished, like, the one we're in right now?
All right, no need to crass. No need to be crass.
Return to the church altar. Wait, the church altar? Are we going to break it? We're going to do a little breaky break?
No spirit may cross the threshold, eh? Well then, I'll just have to invite one in myself.
You eye a flat surface on the barren altar. It looks like a perfect place to conduct a seance. A seance? Yes.
Spirit aboard.
Okay. What do I need? Dog hair. Okay, that one's easy. Here. And here. Okay, I just need some dog hair. You know, I'm going through a lot of trouble to get this banshee over here. This better work. Just to straight up get the soul of the rat. Invoke. You close your eyes. I don't know if the microphone caught that, but fuck, my voice went very squeaky. You close your eyes and place your hands on the planchette of the spirit board. Concentrating hard, you try to focus your thought towards the haunted mansion.
Hello? Can you hear me? Show me a sign.
The planchette begins to twitch and move, slowly tracing out letters on the board.
Who is this?
Oh, come down. Who else would it be? I'm calling to let you know I found where the rat is. You might want to come down here and speak to it.
The lights flicker within the halls and dim down until you're drenched in total darkness. Until a blood-red glow throbs from the altar. Wind rushes through the church and you can hear the squealing of rats as they dive for cover. On the gale come the screams of the dead reverberating through the halls. The spirit board shudders and splits with the noise. God damn, And a skeletal hand draws its way out from the people of Crack's planchette. God. Not only can I not read, I'm also having hiccups.
He's here! I can smell him!
Right through that crack in the wall, actually.
The vengeful spirit howls and flies straight through your body as she sweeps down to the rat's hideout.
Brr, that's chilly. Oh, wait for me. I need to see how this ends.
Wait for me, Banshee. I want to see the rat squeal.
Let's just squeeze the life out of him.
Oh, there you are. You dirty for me.
How did you wait? It was just a simple misunderstanding. I didn't. Even in your hour of judgment, you lie!
The rat's bulging eyes look onto you in desperation.
This is your doing, isn't it? Let me in here. You let her in here.
I'm merely helping us settle a dispute. You thought all your grave robbing wouldn't come with consequences?
Face justice for your crimes, thief! The dead have come for you!
The banshee swirls around like a hurricane, drawing with her innumerable hosts of ghosts and spirits.
No, no, get off us! You wretched! You are dead! Find us keepers!
Spectral claws grab onto the rat and his verminous minions and drag them squealing into the underworld. Okay. With a crack of thunder and howling wind evaporates to a single rat remains, a calm over the banshee as she reaches the big scattered left of the floor.
My brooch, it's back. It's safe. I can finally sleep.
She clutches her treasure and her breast. Wait. Right. Her, like, the area, not the... God looks to deal with a final crooked smile, like before fading away, a glimmer goes to spoke. In the ears of the game, she's still squirming in the debris.
Ugh.
You brush aside a bit of her treasure and uncover a writhing mass of pink rat tails tangled together like worms.
Yeah, a thing called Rat King, which is a real thing. Looks like y'all got knotted up, up trying to escape. The soul of the rat.
You can look it up. There's a thing called the Rat King, which is basically several rats. I don't know exactly what it is, but I believe it's like their tails get so like disgustingly like unclean that the grime basically like ties their tails together, sort of. It's fucking ridiculous and disgusting. All right. Unicorn, I got something for you.
A good snack, I'll perk you right up.
Riverall. The miserable... The miserable creature dips its snout and investigates the tasty dessert.
Is this for me?
It troubles me to see a benevolent beast afflicted by such melancholy. And the quicker the horn of yours wears, the quicker we can sort out this mess.
Throwing back its head, the unicorn swallows the odd confection without even chewing. The spots on his back glow a soft lavender, and his hoofed feet levitate off the ground for just a moment. From above, a thin sliver of sunlight breaks through the clouds, a sparkle of the unicorn's horn momentarily blinding you in a dazzling flash. When you look back, the unicorn happily wagging its tail at you, a turn looks reinvigorated with a pearlescent sheen.
Oh, that hit the spot. Looks like the old truth detector was working again.
Well, what are you waiting for? Bless those fools.
The unicorn lowers its horn to take aim at the feuding shopkeepers, and a long moment passes as the unicorn's body quivers with anticipation.
Huh.
Wait, I swear, no, this never happens. My powers are all charged up, but none of them are actually lying.
So they really did sabotage each other's businesses, then?
My horn will only be able to blast the lies out of someone who's truly false. As far as they know, they're each telling the truth.
Yeah, so it's believed truth, not real truth.
Huh, which means someone else must be responsible for this mess.
The feuding shopkeepers run into the insults, hurl each other, store back the business.
I'll go investigate to see the crimes of the shops. Maybe I can turn some clues.
Really? Oh, no. Oh, I can get fish from there. That was my complete accident, but I thought it was one of the guys that I needed to speak to, but one of them said they were a blacksmith, right? I don't remember the voice I gave you, so I'm just gonna maybe not do it, or maybe I could just watch the episode where I did that, which I think was two episodes ago.
Hey, that blasted Chandler! I wring your scrawny neck!
Calm yourself, Master Blacksmith. You're being played for a fool.
Ha! Fat chance. Only some hard evidence could ever convince me that it was that blundering knave.
If someone really has been sneaking around in here, there ought to be some clues left behind.
Only evidence could possibly change my mind.
Cat's confession. Oh, sure. Why not? Get ordinary supplies. Oh, disturbed coal. Some firewood has been hastily shoved into the coal barrel. Take the firewood rich property or Town watch if lost, police return to village gallows. Completely mundane. Alright. Now, just to do one thing. Figure out what gallows are. I've heard the name before, so I do feel like I know it's somewhere in the back of my head, but I don't remember. Okay, from what I could see, it was this. Yeah, okay. meaning that I actually looked online what gallows are, and it's a raised ground something. You peer through the slated planks of town gallows to... It doesn't look like it's seen much use recently. The space underneath is stuffed with evidence storage of parade decoration, including a box of dusty fireworks. An errant note catches your eye, but you can't quite fit your hand through the wooden planks.
Drat! I need something thin and grabby.
Is it a pluck? Yep. A pluck pocket. There we go. You plug on the slip of paper onto the gallows. It looks like a torn notebook. When you discovered, she's writing this. No doubt has been witness to the greatest crime spree. The cat, right.
I, the cat, will be remembered throughout history as the greatest underground mastermind. The town, Flatfoot, will never notice a couple parade fireworks missing, and that blacksmith buffoon will lose more than a few chest hairs.
I'm trying to mimic the voice it did before, but that goddamn.
How arrogant. This proof ought to convince the blacksmith of the cat's involvement.
Fair enough. Actually, while I'm here, I made a skeleton key. Mimic's toe. I didn't want the... Oh, Mr. Brex... Oh, Mr. Brexmeter, I have evidence for you.
Only evidence could possibly this moment.
Cast confession. The man's beady eyes go wide and the angry reads through the paper.
Why that no good cat? The whole mac and cheese could have gone off in a big ball of fire.
I take it you'll let the Chandler off the hook.
Sure, sir. Looks like he wasn't involved in this plot, though. I still don't care for the standards much.
Excellent. Maybe with you three at peace, we can get to the bottom of this.
Fair enough. Now, I don't actually know where they are, but I am going to assume, as with the blacksmith, that there is a that they're in houses. That's what I was trying to say. What was your voice again?
Grr, that oafish blacksmith just grinds my gears. I ought to give him a smack on the brow next I see him.
Master Baker, please, settle down. You've been tricked.
Ha! I very much doubt that. Only a fool would believe that story without any evidence.
Fine, you want evidence? I'll get you some. A true criminal must have left clues around here somewhere.
Oh, what have you got? Fuck it. Okay, fine. Completely mundane. This thing. Nope. Oh, I didn't take anything. There we go. Strange, dirt inside, description inside, reads. Okay, nothing out of the ordinary. Visit the old hanging tree in the graveyard. Hanged ghost. The crooked fellow peers down at you as if someone else is coming to make fun of his eternal predicament. Just put a piece of paper floating inside the translucent body.
What do you got there? Don't suppose I can convince you to go out and cut the paper up, can I?
Spirit salts. Okay. This thing. Fair enough. You sprinkle the exorcising salts onto the ghost. He sputters and sneezes. The paper suspended inside it as before going back to swings. Nothing happened.
Looks like the page has so much diary. My best plan yet. These graze bugs will make a baker's buns taste like embalmed eclairs. I'll just dump the dirt out of the stupid urn to carry them. This should be proof enough to convince the baker it was a real culprit was.
Take it. God damn, what do you need to make me go all the way? technically I need to go all over the place to gather ingredients, but still. Excuse me, Baker Man, I have evidence! I forgot your voice. already. Proud person, angry, cast confession. You'll forgive the blacksmith then.
Huh? Right, sure. Doesn't look like he's involved in this at all.
Splendid. If you think you can get along enough, we can bring this culprit to justice. Fair enough. Now, where is the fucking candle? Okay, it's down there. I have no idea. We'll see. I did go around. What? Oh, you took my jar. Wait. Hold up. What? Is that how I lost my healing? I don't have fire. God damn it, you piece of shit. Anyways. Hi there.
That insufferable baker. I'll tear his nose off next time I see him.
Settle down, Master Chandler. You're being duped by a prankster.
Ha! A prankster? It was that baker, I'm sure of it. I don't see no evidence to the contrary.
You want evidence, eh? Yeah, that's cool right here.
Get some evidence or get out.
Fair enough. Okay, not this. Or actually, maybe that. Nope. Completely mundane. Yeah, barrel. Okay. Not the barrel, because it doesn't count. Oh, hey, a chest. I'll take it. Ordinary supplies. There's this thing. There's this thing. What? Oh, what? This bag smells sulfur. Docker. Okay, fair enough. Investigate gate pier 3. I was on the right side, which was 4 and 5, so. Oh, the pelican, maybe. Or. Maybe not. Ah. This is the shipping address for the sulfur crates, but you don't find anything incriminating. You do, however, spot some of them wedged between the watery piles of the pier.
Something must have gotten knocked out of the docks for purposely disposed of. So we'll do take a close look-see.
Fish out the
How? What?
Oh, I can make it. Oh! Okay, then. You fish out an empty sulfur tin with a wad of wet paper stuffed inside. Though the ink is running, you can still make it out in loop handwriting.
Another brilliant strategy by the world's most brilliant strategist. That's me, the cat. If you're reading this, then be sure to write my name down in the history books. The sulfur smells so rotten it will put those candlesticks the Chandler makes a little trash. He'll think the baker did it when the dust is off his floor.
Well then, this is the proof that Chandler's looking for. Fair enough. Cast confession. Chandler's cheeks flushed a bright red, stomping his shadow to cast confession.
Why that yowling pest? That's my whole livelihood she's meddling with.
You agree the baker's innocent then?
Looks like he didn't have a hand in this horrible crime, though his bread's still stale, if you ask me.
As long as you three put a stop to this ruckus, we'll be able to get to the rudge.
I'll keep my eyes on the peel of that darn cat. She won't show her nose around here again, that's for sure.
So this fetch quest of items, it felt kind of annoying because when you need items to craft something to use on there, that feels like, yeah, I need to do it to further on. But then this feels more like you have to do it to further on. Like, instead of you thinking yourself that you need to... Ah, goddamn. Instead of thinking for yourself, the game is basically forcing you. Even though both of them are technically that.
Now that these three fellows have cooled down a bit, I better have a chat with that plump purple pony to figure out the best way to confront the swindler.
To confront the swindler?
Oh, purple unicorn! Hello.
Oh, Joy, you're back. Did you finish anything at the shops? Did you find anything at the shop?
It would appear the art market is plagued by the mastermind schemes of the cat. Well, maybe not so masterminded. She did leave behind a bunch of clues for me to find.
As though summoned up, your furry shape somersaults onto the nearby roof with a flourish.
I see, you're a fan of my genius accomplishments. Well, you're in luck. Soon I'll have this whole village to my mercy. Quickly, your magic horn!
The unicorn shuffles its stumpy legs and gets a better shot at the monologuing feline. With a flick of her tail, the cat disappears, leaving only her voice cackling in the air.
You'll have to be faster than that, slowpokes.
Oh, no. I'm sorry. I'm not very maneuverable in high-pressure situations.
Ah, don't fret. We'll just make sure she stands still next time. I should be able to concoct a tranquilizing kitty treat strong enough to keep her attention.
Okay, hold up. What do I need for it? First of all, this. Okay. Okay. And one more thing. Okay. This thing. Pigeon beak. And blue feather. What? Oh. These things. But how do I can't do a bait stick, can I? I just remembered this thing. I remember using it in the forest against two different things. Okay, let's just see. Oh. Okay, good. Good enough for me. And what was the other thing? Blue feather. So I need to capture more birds. You know, it's kind of embarrassing for the cat to be captured with this. Okay. You blaze down the scrumptious looking cat tree and duck behind a pumpkin to hide. Within moments, you hear the telltale laughter of the cat.
That's the best you could do. What do you take me for, a ballistic alley cat? You'll need more than a lumber carriage to catch me.
Despite her lofty words, you see her eyes go wide and her tail flick. As the scent of fish and catnip reaches her nose.
Why, it's the most sophisticated criminal underlord this world seems to see. What is that, tuna?
You gave the signal to the unicorn, but see the beast is still facing entirely the wrong direction.
Must it do everything around here?
Prompt the... Oh, right. You slap the unicorn's haunches, jolting out of the daydream.
Oh, right, the cat.
The beast carefully aims his signal to speed of direction.
All right, I've got her this time. By the light of the trail, I banish all lies from thee.
A brilliant spark of rainbow light emits from the unicorn's horn and streaks towards the preoccupied cat. Oh, no. When the colorful smoke clears, you can't see hide nor hair of the cat. Only a smoldering pair of fancy leather boots remain near the statue.
Wow, for a moment there, I thought all that talk about your magic horn was pure hogwash.
I mean, usually it doesn't have such an explosive effect. I only meant to expel the lies from her, but I guess she was all lies. Didn't have truthful bone in her body.
Well, whatever the reason, I suppose it won't be blighting your market any longer.
Yes, that's right. Can't wait for life to get back to normal. Thank you for all your help.
You guys, one of the cat's boots slapped over to gather her up. You pick up the smoky boots of the cat, a rainbow hue radiates off the leather. This smells strongly of feet and candy. Ugh. The soul of the cat, though you suspect she may have 8 more lives left. You sense the soul of the fish, cat, rat, and ram. Pulsed with cat. Why didn't you do it? A cat, rat, fish, ram? It flows better. Pulse with the captain malignancy.
The goat will be wanting to take custody of these four. Best not keep him waiting.
I'll go over there. But I have run out of time. Spent way too much time on the ghost. And the. The ghost and cat things. Alright. Anyways, we'll go back home. That's about it. Don't have time to do the other thing. So, for now, I think I'm just going to end this here. We'll see what happens next time. So, this is Quazzar signing out, and I'll see y'all next time. Thanks so much for watching. Bye-bye.